In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of tibialis posterior. Tibialis posterior. This is very, very deep muscle in lower leg. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let me talk about its origin. Origin is kind of broad. Origin is posterior part of tibia and posterior part of fibula. Posterior part of tibia and fibula. Plus, there is connective tissue between tibia and fibula. This is interosseous membrane. Interosseous membrane. This membrane is very important for lower leg movement and ankle movement. So if this muscle gets tight, it tightens up interosseous membrane. Thus, tightness of interosseous membrane can inhibit movement of lower leg and ankle joint. This mechanics is very, very important. Anyway, origin is posterior part of tibia and fibula and interosseous membrane. Let me talk about its insertion. So this is inferior view of foot. This is tibialis posterior. Actually, insertion is very, very broad. It attaches on so many bones, okay? It attaches on navicular. Navicular, right here. Navicular plus cuboid. Cuboid and all cuneiform bones. There are three cuneiforms, so I write three cuneiform. Three cuneiforms plus second through fourth metatarsal. So it attaches on right here, this area, navicular, cuboid, all cuneiforms, and second through fourth metatarsal. See, this is very, very broad insertion. Before I'm going to explain its function, let me talk about its orientation. This is medial view. This is tibialis posterior. It's on deep part. It runs posterior to legs, then it goes to medial part of ankle and foot. And do you remember? It attaches on so many tarsal bones. Okay, right here. Remember, this is posterior part. And it goes to medial part. And it goes to plantar part. Posterior, medial, and foot. This orientation is very important to understand its function. So, what is function of tibialis posterior? When muscle contracts, that brings joint this way. What kind of movement is that? That is plantar flexion. Plantar flexion. And remember, it runs on medial part of ankle joint. So it does inversion. Inversion. Okay, this is the main function of tibialis posterior. Plantar flexion and inversion. One more important thing. Because tibialis posterior is very, very deep muscle, it has something to do with maintaining of arch of foot. So it supports medial longitudinal arch. Supports medial longitudinal arch. You don't have to remember exact terminology, just remember tibialis posterior supports medial part of foot arch. So important. If this muscle gets tight, it inhibits ankle movement, foot movement, plus it can aggravate foot arch. You know, arch of foot is so important. Foot is base of body. If this mechanics is aggravated, that can affect whole part of body. That is why mechanics of foot arch is crucial. Tibialis posterior has something to do with foot arch. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of tibialis posterior. I explained its origin, insertion, and function. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.